it is very important to understand which feature selection method will work properly for their model. As a thumb rule, the more we know about the data types of variables used, the easier it is to choose the appropriate statistical measure for feature selection. To know this, we first need to identify the type of input and output variables and understand them. In machine learning, variables are of mainly two types. Numerical variables, which are variables with continuous values such as integer, float, etc. And categorical variables, which are variables with categorical values such as Boolean, ordinal, or nominal. Once you are done with this, you should understand the nature of your problem. Different feature selection methods are better suited for different types of data and machine learning algorithms. Consider the factors like type of prediction task, is it classification, regression, or clustering? Nature of your data, is it tabular, text, images, or time series? The size of the dataset, as large datasets might require more computationally efficient methods. Now, for ease of understanding, let's take a case of some univariate statistical measures which can be used for filter-based feature selection. Please note that there might be other methods that you can also use. I'm simply sharing the most common ones. Number one, numerical input, numerical output. Now, numerical input variables are used for predictive regression modeling. The common methods to be used for such a case is the correlation coefficient. Further, for this, you can use methods like Pearson's correlation coefficient for linear correlation and Spearman's rank coefficient for non-linear correlation. Number two, numerical input, categorical output. Now, numerical input with categorical output is the case for classification predictive modeling. In this case, also correlation-based techniques should be used, but with categorical output. Further, for this, you can use methods like ANOVA correlation coefficient for linear and Kendall's rank coefficient for non-linear. Number three, categorical input and numerical output. This is the case of regression predictive modeling with categorical input, but it is a different example of a regression problem. We can use the same measures as discussed in the previous case, but in reverse order. Number four, categorical input, categorical output. This is a case of classification predictive modeling with categorical input variables. The commonly used techniques for such a case is chi-squared test. We can also use information gain in this case as well. We can summarize the discussed cases with appropriate measures in this table. Lastly, never forget to account for the following considerations. Number one, interpretability versus accuracy. Sometimes simpler models are preferable for interpretability even if it means sacrificing some accuracy. Number two, domain knowledge. As utilizing domain knowledge to guide initial feature selection is a good move, especially in specialized areas. Number three, validation. As regardless of the method chosen, validating the effectiveness of feature selection with cross-validation techniques is always a good idea to avoid overfitting. In conclusion, I'd like to say that there's no one-size-fits-all method for feature selection. The best approach depends on the specific characteristics of your dataset, the machine learning algorithm you plan to use, and the problem you're trying to solve. Experimenting with different methods and validation strategies is key to finding the most effective feature set for your model. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you like my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.